With 14 years of experience in iOS development, I've seen it all. From the evolution of Objective-C to the power of SwiftUI today. Having a mentor with this depth of experience means you'll benefit from proven strategies, real-world insights, and a clear path to mastering SwiftUI without wasting time on trial and error. My mentoring sessions are built in over a decade of hands-on experience, helping you avoid common mistakes, solve complex problems, and adopt industry best practices. If you want to elevate your skills and learn SwiftUI from someone who's been in the trenches, my mentorship is your shortcut to success. If you have a bug in your code, if you want to learn SwiftUI, or if you want to have an advice from a senior iOS developer, make sure to check out the link in the description. It's rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, today, we are going to go further from our previous episode about TipKit. We are going to have some groups. We are going to have also some events, and we are also going to have some parameters. I am looking at my code right over here. This is what we left off previously. Let me just add back in our hello world. And what I was talking about at the end of our tutorial, previous tutorial, is that these two tips are just coming up together. As you can see, we have a tip on the text, and we have also a tip on the image. Well, we want to have some sort of an order first. So that is what we are going to tackle first. We are going to create a tip group. As you can see, we have an image tip and a text tip right over here, which is kind of, you know, it's just going to be created at the same time. That's why it is presented at the same time. And if you don't really know how to present all of these, go ahead and check out the previous video. The link for the playlist is also in the description. So we are going to not use these tips like they are declared right over here. We are going to actually create a tip group. So let's do that. Private var, or you could just have a let because it's a constant, tip group. There we go. And then let's just say it is a tip group. And we are going to add our image tip and then our text tip. There we go, text tip. So, okay, nothing has really changed because we are not using our tip group. What we want to do is instead of using the image tip, we are going to use the tip group dot, and then you are going to use the current tip. Okay, that's fine. Let's just add that also to our popover. Instead of the text tip, we are going to use that one right over here inside the actions too. Okay, so we want to make these optionals because they are optionals. Let's take care of those errors first. But actually nothing has really changed. We still have these two tips popping up. Well, that is because the current tip could be basically anything. So any of those that we have set up right over here, an image tip or a text tip. So what we want to do is just set on the tip view, because this is using the image tip, we want to use as ? Image tip. And right over here on the popover, we want to use as text tip. And now you will see that it is showing the first one, the image tip, just right over there. Really, really nice. Now, when I'm going to press on either of these, and remember, we have set up the actions and all of that stuff, we are invalidating. Make sure to check out the previous video. It will just change it. I don't know, it just changed it. You can't really see it right over here, but it just went to the next tip. And let's just change the order because this is kind of not user-friendly. I don't really see that it has been changed. So what I'm going to do is just change the order. So text tip is going to be shown first and then the image tip. So here we have our text tip. Let's change to the greeting of hello TipKit. There we go. And now we can see the second tip. That is the image tip. And now we just change it to dog. Much, much nicer. TipKit's parameter and event features make it a game changer for creating a tailored and effective user learning experience in your app. Parameters allow you to customize tips based on specific user contexts, while events let you track user interactions and trigger tips at the perfect moment. These features ensure that your tips feel relevant and actionable, guiding users seamlessly through your app's functionality. In this video, you'll get a hands-on step-by-step walkthrough of how to utilize TipKit's parameters and events, unlocking its full potential to deliver smarter, context-aware tips on your SwiftUI apps. So this is how you kind of set up the order. But what if you want to have a more fine-grained presentation of your tips? And this is where parameters and events come in. So for that, this is just fine for the image and the text view. I have also a button right over here, which we did not use in the previous video, but we are going to use it today. So for that, I'm just going to count up, and according to the count, we are going to present some sort of a tip. Let's create our tip first. Remember, we have the image tip and the text tip right over here. You can set it up in a separate file if you wish to. Let's just have another one. So struct, and let's just name this count tip. Okay, of type tip, and then we are going to have a title. Well, I'm going to say tap the button to count up for our title. I'm going to paste it in there. Okay, and then we should have also a message. Oh, it did add it over here. Let's just see. The text will change when you tap it. I'm copying this out and pasting it in because to save time. And then we are going to have an image of system name with the hand, not over there, but over here. Okay, so that's fine. I don't really actually need any actions on this one, but that's fine. So how can we use this count tip? Well, actually what I'm going to do is just set it up as an inline tip. So let's scroll all the way up to our button. It's right over here. I'm going to add tip view, and then let's just have simple count tip. Oh, we do need to create it first, so let me just copy it out, and then, well, we can remove these two, and let's have the private let count tip equals count tip, just like that. There we go. So, yeah, tap the button to count up. The text will change when you tap it. Okay, so yeah, it does change right over here, the text 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and of course, we can just dismiss it if we want to. Really, really nice. But what I actually want to do is just have some sort of a rule. And let's just say, if we are going to tap on it, on the button, we should present our tip. If we tap on it again, let's dismiss it. And if we tap on it the third time, let's present it again. So just a simple logic right over here, which actually presents a good way of using parameters. So let's go down to our count tip and let's create a parameter right over here. So at parameter, there we go. You may have some options transient. So we're just going to, whenever you actually make the parameter valid, then it's just going to put it back to its default value. A simple parameter will just work fine for this tutorial. So static var is button tabbed of type bool equals false. So this is our parameter. Now let's set up some rules according to that parameter. Basically just one rule, but there's an array of rules and we are going to cover that too. So we need to set up our rule, var rules. As you can see, it's an array of rules. And yeah, let's just see. Well, this is not the rule that I actually want, so I'm going to write it out myself. So we can see it's an array. Let's add our first one. So let's add our rule and then self dot, and then dollar sign is button tabbed. What do we want to do? Well, we want to set dollar sign zero when equals true. So when the is button tabbed is going to be changed, we are going to set it to true. Now, of course, not dollar sign. Let's see, where is that? There we go. So let's see how can we connect all of this. Well, what we are going to do is say when we are tapping on this button, as you can see, it's just counting up one. We are going to say count tip dot is button tapped dot toggle. So we're just going to toggle it. Really nice. So when we're toggling it, we are just saying true, false, whenever is button is set to true, we are going to present the count tip. Currently it's false. So as you can see, it's not over there. So let's just tap on the button and it's presented. And then tap on the button again. We are toggling the is button tapped to false. Therefore, we are removing the count tip. And again, same thing goes if we tap on the button continuously again. So that's fine, okay. But what if I want to present this tip whenever a certain number of taps have been added? So the count is at a certain number. We can do that really easily with an event. So let's create that event. I'm going to remove the rule for now. We don't need that rule. Of course, I'm going to also set it up in just a second. So both the parameter and the event will work. But let's just focus on the event for now. This is a static. Well, actually, it's a let. It could be a constant. So did trigger tab button event. And this is an event. And all you have to do is just set up an ID. And I believe the same will be. It has to be unique, of course, for this tip. The trigger but event is just fine. So now what we need to do is just set up a rule for this event. self.didTriggerButton event. And then what these events have are, whenever we trigger the event, they are called donations. So we are going to donate trigger, donate another trigger when we are tapping it again. So we're going to say $donations.count is greater than 5. So not the first one, but it should be greater than 5. So now let's see how this will work. So let's just tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the next one, well, actually it did not go through. So let's see what happened over here. Remember, we needed to kind of trigger is button tab. Well, we did that right over here. We need to do the same thing for the events. So just go count tip dot did trigger button event. And you remember I said we are donating. So donate. And basically, that's it. If I'm correct, yes. This is an asynchronous function, so we should add that into a task. So task and then await. There we go. So now it should actually work. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And on the next one, we are just going to simply show the button. And of course, we can move all the way up because it's still larger than 5, the donation counts. And of course, we may remove it with the X. Now, let's combine the two. I'm going to enable this is button tab. And also, I'm going to enable the first rule that we have created. This is an array, so we need to add a comma right over here. So our rules now state that the button should be tapped at least 5 times. And the is button tabbed should be set to true. So let's just count up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the next one, we are not presenting it because the button tapped is still set to false. Now on the very next one, it's just going to trigger it. And from here on, we are only, you know, we are, the donations are more than 5. We are only going to say, is it true? Yes, then present it. If it's false, do not present it, remove it. So there we go. After that, if we just go all the way up, it's just going to go show and hide. And this is how easy it is to add parameters and events to your tips. And also the first issue that we tackled is the order of how to present these tips inside a tip group. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, make sure to check out developer.com/mentoring. The link is down in the description.